यस, गुड मॉर्निंग। हेलो।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
हाँ, ओके।
गुड मॉर्निंग सर।
सो इन द प्रीवियस क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द मैक्सिमम लाइक्लीहुड डीकोडिंग। मैक्सिमम लाइक्लीहुड डीकोडिंग ओवर ओवर देयर वी हैव जस्ट अ मिनट। Okay, now the screen is a little bit wider. So over there I have given you the basic introduction of what is maximum likelihood decoding, what is the signal vectors and related points, received signal point and other things, which is done in the small recap. And also I have explained the concept of the decision or the detection problem. So in the detection problem, what the receiver will do, the receiver will always compute a metric so that the decision of what does the receiver will do, the receiver, it will try to detect such that the probability of error in the detection is very much less. So that is the main aim of the concept in maximum likelihood decoding. The receiver, what it is going to do, the receiver, it is going to detect in such a way that probability of error is very less. So the probability of error is evident in this particular equation. To have the probability of error to be a very less quantity, the second term, that is p of m I sent given x, this should be maximum. If this is maximum, error probability would be minimum. That is the logic in the entire topic maximum likelihood decoding. Now I'm just revising the previous classes. So what does the receiver will do? It needs to detect. So what it will do is, let us come to the decision rule or the rule. It will compute this particular metric. In this metric there is a variable by name k. K means it tells the message number. It will compute this metric p of mk sent given x for all the messages, and it will tabulate the metric and find the maximum one. Why maximum? This because to reduce the error probability, it will find for which particular message the metric is maximum. So for a particular message, say k is equal to I, then if it happens to be the maximum, then that particular message would be decided at the receiver. Set m cap is equal to mi. If I is equal to 2, what happens is m cap is equal to m2. So this is the basic decision rule. Okay, so based on this particular rule only, we are going to refine this particular rule so that it could be easily implementable in the receiver. Any implementation should be very much easier. So what we are going to do is, we are going to have an easier way of implementation. That is what. So this particular rule, as I told yesterday, is called as maximum a posteriori probability rule. Maximum comes in the decision rule only. We are calculating a metric for a maximum value. Metric is probability. A posteriori means some event needs to be happened. That is why it is called as a posteriori probability. So this was discussed in the earlier class. And also, what extra thing has been done to the previous decision rule was that probability would be expressed in terms of likelihood functions. Likelihood function means, in other words, conditional probability density function, which is read as fx of x given mk. Now the decision rule has been written in terms of conditional probability density function. What is the condition? The condition is this: given mk, this is the condition, you are calculating the fx of x, that is the PDF, probability density function. So the previous decision rule, which is written in this format, has been converted to this format using the Bayes theorem. Okay, currently Bayes theorem is not important. What we need to understand is the terms which are involved in this. Okay, so here you, in the numerator you are having two terms, and the denominator you are having a single term. So if now what does the receiver will do? The it will do the same process. In process madate, it will compute the metric for all messages. So where is the message point? Which variable will refer to the message? MK, K 1 to N. So M1, M2, M3, M4, for all messages, it will compute this metric. Okay. Here, PK is the probability of the message at the source. Probability that the message is going to emit from the source. We will assume that the source is equi, it will emit the messages equiprobable. So, therefore, for whatever the message which is emitted from the source, the probability PK will remain constant. For message M1, PK is same. For message M2, PK is same. For all messages, the probability will be same. Then come to the denominator part. In this denominator part, we are not having any argument related to K. It is only dependent upon the received vector X. But observe the numerator here. It this numerator term fx of x given mk il kantidiyala idu, it depends upon that particular message. So keeping this and removing the other things, pk and fx of x, so we are going to have a new decision rule. Means we are evaluating the metric. In every evaluation, for in every evaluation, in other words, for every message, if when you are evaluating this metric, this PK term and the fx of x term will remain constant. So what we are doing is we are removing those things and we are only keeping which is varying quantity. So for all messages, only computation of this metric fx of x given mk is sufficient. So this fx of x given mk is nothing but the likelihood function, and since you are computing the maximum value, it is called maximum likelihood computation. So till this point we have discussed in the yesterday's class. Now we will move on to the today's discussion, that is the same thing expressed in different ways. Now in the box you are going to see the same expression, but there is another term called as LAN. ಹಳೆದಕ್ಕೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ಇದಕ್ಕೆ ಏನು ವ್ಯತ್ಯಾಸ ಅಂತಂದ್ರೆ, ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ವರ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ನೇಮ್ ಆರ್ ದೇರ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಟರ್ಮ್ ಬೈ ನೇಮ್ LAN. LAN means natural logarithms. Why we are going to use this natural logarithms means to evaluate this fx of x given mk. Over during the evaluation, there comes the exponential term. There comes the exponential term. I repeat, there comes the exponential term. But LAN and exponentials are inverses of each other. So therefore, there would be a little bit easy thing will happen during the computation. So that is why the LAN would be used. So whenever there is usage of LAN, LAN andre LAN alla, network alla, it is natural logarithms. So that means it is called as log likelihood functions, but there is no need to write that. You keep in mind that we are going to use this natural logarithms mainly for simplification purposes. Okay, so this rule would be implemented in the receiver, but whether this would be could this be even simplified, means if I want to develop a receiver, I need to implement this mathematical equation. Is there any chance of improving this mathematical equation? The answer is yes. Below this block of the decision rule, it a diagram. So there was a network glitch. There was a network glitch. There was a network glitch. Okay, so now we are having a diagram. So whether this diagram is visible to you, so let me just stop sharing the screen and just give me whether the screen is being visible to you or not. For a moment, I'm going to stop the sharing. Hello, can anybody respond? Were you getting the screen?
Sir.
ಕೇಳಿಸ್ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ ಒಂದ್ ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ನೆಟ್ವರ್ಕ್ ಗ್ಲಿಚ್ ಇತ್ತು ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಕೇಳಿದೆ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಾ
ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್ ಇವಾಗ ಕಾಣಿಸ್ತಿಲ್ಲ
ಇವಾಗಿಲ್ಲ ಅವಾಗ ಜಸ್ಟ್
ಇಲ್ಲ ಸರ್
ಓಕೆ ನೌ ಲೆಟ್ ಮೀ ಶೇರ್ ದ ಸ್ಕ್ರೀನ್ ಪ್ಲೀಸ್ ನೌ ಈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಅವೈಲಬಲ್ ಎಸ್ ಎಸ್ ಆರ್ ನೋ this diagram wherein you are having the quadrants message point 1 message point 2 is it visible to you
yes sir
yes thank you so let me proceed so now what does this diagram represents is it represents the following thing you are having let us assume you are having four number of messages message 1 2 3 and 4 all messages are plotted as points which are shown in the form of dots you are able to observe message point 1 message point 2 3 and 4 four message points are being plotted on a graph okay so what they are going to do is they are going to divide this entire space this is the space this space into sectors okay each sector belonging to a particular message so I repeat on the Euclidean space they are going to plot the message points and they will identify the sectors so the word sector is not a technical word currently so it should be called as a decision region why it is called as a decision region means if at all you get a received signal you convert that received signal into a vector and if it falls in this particular region please see the mouse pointer if it falls in the region z1 then what does the receiver will do the receiver will decide that yes message 1 might be transmitted so that is why this region will be called as the decision regions they are going to have some decision regions around every message points so here you are having four message points so you are having four decision regions which are named as z1 region z2 region z3 z4 so on and so forth how many messages so many number of decision regions so now what we are doing is we are going to give a graphical representation to the maximum likelihood rule so anybody can observe this diagram and can say if at all the received signal falls in this region z1 then one can say that message point m1 has been transmitted if the received signal falls somewhere in the region z3 what one can say yes signal 3 or message 3 might be transmitted could this concept be extracted from this particular decision rule so whatever I said now just now can I convert that into mathematics that is the question the answer is yes so we will go on observing now you are able to get what is this diagram for and what are the regions and all so let me proceed to the next slide yes so the decision rule has been rewritten just observe decision rule in terms of decision regions over there the first line has been modified I repeat the decision rule has been modified the first line in the decision rule is modified it says vector x lies in the region zi what does this typically mean vector x lies in the region zi. What does that mean? See, let us assume that this is zi. Your received vector x are, remember one thing here, the vector and the point, the word vector and the word point, it will be used interchangeably. So when I say vector, you should also think it as a point. When I say point, you should think it as a vector. So both in your mind, it should run like that. Okay. So now what I'm telling is, instead of writing set m cap is equal to mi, I am using a new sentence. Yenanta word use martini, m cap is equal to mi andre, your decision is mi has been transmitted. As far as this diagram is concerned, when will you say that message one is being transmitted if the received vector or the received signal falls in the region zi, then what can I say? Set m cap is equal to m1. That is what. So what I want to tell is, I am going to write this sentence, yado ee words idavala, set m cap is equal to mi, in terms of geometry or in terms of this decision regions. So yen martini, set m cap, I'm not going to say set m cap, it would be said as follows. M cap is equal to mi anta helala, what does this mean? M cap is equal to a particular message and the detection helate, receiver helate. So over here, what am I going to say is, the received vector falls in the region z1, athara heltini illa, received vector falls in the region z2, received vector falls in the region z3. That if I say, what does this mean? Received vector falls in the region z1 andre, okay, message 1 has been transmitted, or in other words, m cap is equal to mi anta artha. So this has been rewritten in the forum like this: vector x or point x or received signal point x or observation vector x lies in the region zi. This is the only thing which has been changed. So the second line, this is left unchanged. You can verify this is left unchanged. So now what we are doing is, with this LAN and conditional probability function, or the other word likelihood, so let us remove these terms and try to have some geometrical terms. So is it possible? The answer is as follows. See, this is the likelihood function. Among this, which is the likelihood function? Fx of x given mk. So likelihood function ge innond hesru probability density function. Remember, a PDF appears for a random quantity. Okay, so for this particular random quantity x, the likelihood function is defined as follows. So currently this expression has been taken from the previous topic, that is conversion of AWGN channel to vector channel. The same expression has been taken. Adrindane tagondide. You can, if you are having your notes, you can cross check. Ali only thing is the variable name mk badlu ali mi anta ide, only that is the small only change. Okay, so this equation has been taken. You need to remember this equations. Okay, if you know about the probability and other things, then it would be very much easier. Okay, currently let us concentrate on this. Okay, now the PDF or the likelihood is given as follows. Now we are computing the ln, LAN anakinta ln anana natural logarithms anta. So LAN of this means the exponential term would vanish out and this expression would come down to this particular thing. So just observe this. So compared to the exponential term, this is somewhat complicated compared to the second equation, or in other words, the second equation is simpler when compared to the first equation. How this has happened? We have computed the metric as LAN of fx of x given mk. So LAN of this would give you this particular expression. So exponential has been reduced. Just observe this carefully. Fx of x formula ide, to that we have applied LAN. So ln and exponential will get cancelled out, leaving this particular terms. So now in your decision rule, itara ln anta idiyala idru badlo you can substitute this much terms. These two terms na you can substitute over here. Okay. So once you substitute, what instead of ln of some this argument, so what are you having? You are having two terms. You are having two terms. Okay, so that is minus n by 2 ln of pi into n naught minus 1 by n naught j is equal to 1, so on. You are observing. So over here, just observe among these two, should I retain both the things, or can I cancel out anything? So just observe the first term over here. So the first term, this one, it would be computed for all messages. N is a constant, n naught is a constant. All this particular term, all the values which is present in the term are constant. So therefore, during the metric evaluation, this term is of no significance. Okay, so therefore what we will do is we will retain only the second term, that is minus 1 by n naught sigma j is equal to 1 xj minus skj whole square. We are going to retain only this particular term. Okay, based on this explanation, so now the decision rule has been rewritten. Okay, it is as follows. The first it would be changed, so only one, the second term has been retained. Yavdara second term, so the second term of this has been retained. Nodi ln badlu you need to substitute this, so this quantity is of no significance, so we need to use the second quantity, so that has been written over here. Okay, so now all of you know minus and maximum ide. So what I am going to do is, in the second step, I am going to remove the minus. Since we are removing this minus sign, maximum will be converted to minimum. This is a very simple logic. So this, like till here we have arrived. So in we will stop here for one yara nimshadalli stop martini, because of the running time is running out, so therefore I am stopping. So initially nama equations engittu, I hope you remember, this was the equation. Set m cap is equal to mi. Don't worry about this. Just worry about this thing, ln of fx of x. So this has been converted to, I repeat, that has been converted to, ln of the conditional probability density function has been converted to some sigma term, which involves j is equal to 1 to n xj minus skj whole square is minimum for k is equal to I. Till this particular point, the decision rule has been refined. Okay, so now we will stop here. So we will just analyze this rule, final rule, in the coming class. Okay, so I am stopping the screen sharing. Can any participant respond? Can anyone respond? Hello? Hello? Hello?
Yes, sir.
We will stop here, because only time left out is six minutes. So we are I am stopping. I will share the slide today in the Google Classroom, because I was updating it continuously. So anyhow, today evening I will share the slides along with the notes of this, so that it would be easy to read. Okay, so first two concepts arthagli anta I have given the slides. So once you understand the concept, then read the notes. Directly reading the notes, you may not get the concept. That is why I have not uploaded till this particular point. Is it okay? Is it okay? Yes, please.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, I am stopping the meeting. Okay, stopping the meeting. I am canceling the meeting. Okay, thank you.